Welcome back to your English class, children. Today, as a continuation of our discourses, we learn another major discourse. Okay, and this major discourse is given in the paper 2. And paper 2 indicates what textbook independent question will be given, not based on the topics you have learned or the stories you have read in the textbook, but independently. So something which is related to the society or something which is outside the textbook is asked. Okay, children. And this is also for 10 marks. Major is given for 10 marks. And this comes in your paper 2. And today we are going to learn about letter writing. So I hope you all are having a minimum idea what a letter is. So what do we do with a letter? Why do we use a letter? Generally, okay, coming to the purpose of the letter. A letter is a written communication. Communicate means what? To say something or to pass some information to the other person. Okay. So a letter is a written communication. Okay. A written form of communication for giving a purpose, giving an information, or sending some text to someone, or also for spreading some information to the people. It may be of different types, like you may also share your feelings with your friends, relatives, or a close person. Or there are also different type of letters where some information is actually spread to the people, that is communicated to the group of people. Or official purposes also certain information is sent through letters. So like this, different purposes we use letter writing. Okay, based on the purpose we divide them into two different types. Actually, we have two different types of letters. Okay. So, what is a letter? Just to write out, it is a written communication written on a purpose. Okay, but for passing on some information to the purpose. Okay, there should be a purpose of writing a letter. That purpose should be conveyed, communicated to the other person in a written form. So, something which is conveyed in a written form is called letter writing. Okay. But what we are asked in our paper is based on your SSC pattern. Okay, maybe 8th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, whichever class is asked. We will be asked two types of letters. Basically, there are two types. Okay, basically going to the types of letters, there are only two. That is formal and informal. So the word, general word, what we use is generally your teachers, what they say is formal letter, that is official letter. So by the word official itself, you can understand that it is used for official purposes. So what we do when we are writing official letter, it will follow a particular method of writing, a pattern of writing, some formality will be there, and it should be completely professional. Okay. And one more point what you should remember is it should be direct mark. You should not drag the information or whatever information we want to pass on through a official letter or a formal letter. We pass the information directly to the person whom we want to pass the information through the letter, in the form of a letter. Okay. But coming to the informal, it is also called unofficial. The word itself indicates that it is not for office purposes. Okay. So what we will do is, we will convey our personal feelings or whatever we have felt, whatever we have experienced. So sometimes we like to convey our feelings to our friends, acquaintances, relatives, or your parents, or your siblings, okay, whomever it is. So there you are going to convey your personal feelings or information. Okay. So that's why there is no need of professionalism there. There is no need of following a particular pattern or formality. Remember these two differences. Okay, ma'am. So based on these two activities, okay, they are divided into formal and informal. But based on the purpose, okay, the reason of writing the letter, okay, how we are writing the letter, whom we are writing the letter, why we are writing the letter, okay. So some different types of letters are also there. Like that. So coming to the different types, first I told about formal, informal, and the third one is social letter. I am particularly using the word social letter. What do you mean by that? So generally, it is also a type of informal letter, ma, a personal letter. It may be informal and formal both. Like if you want to invite a person, or if you want to congratulate a person on his achievement or something, or sometimes if someone is dead, someone expired, okay, you are going to give some message or express your feelings. Those type of letters are called condolence letters. Okay, so these letters are called what? Inviting some function or giving information about some event which is going to take place authoritatively in an official manner, or invitation socially. Okay, it comes under informal. So like this, these type of letters are called social letters. Okay, coming to the next type, employment letters also will be there. The word employment itself, it is indicating that. What is the purpose used? It is generally used in the process of employment, like appointing someone, giving an appointment letter, that is also in the form of letter. And after getting an appointment letter, a person should join in the office taking permission of the higher authority there. So that is called joining letters. Okay, promotions. Some people are promoted to the higher position, then also a letter is given. Officially a letter, a document is given. That is called a employment letters. But these type of letters are called employment letters and business letters. The word business itself indicates that to promote a business. Okay, it may be related to some quotations of the whatever the item they are going to publish. Quotation means what actually? There will be some auctions going on. Some work will be provided to the group of people through auction. There the quotation should be sent. So that type of information for advertising. Okay, that is for publicizing a product. Also, sometimes we need to send letters, request letters to the other associates, like higher officials in the business, in the offices. Even for them also we send letters. So business letter includes what I told. Generally for promotions, publicizing something, quotations will be there. Okay, even complaint letters on some issues. If you have any issue, ma, you can also write a complaint letter on the particular society, public authority, particular office. So like this, different types of letters which are related to business activities are come under business. So these are also completely professional, and they should follow a particular formalities. That is, a particular pattern should be followed while writing the letter. So in this way, letters are of different types. But broadly speaking, up to your standard, you should know that different type of letters. So that is the reason I gave you in detail. But actually, you are asked only two types. One is formal and informal. So coming to the formal and informal, informal, what I told, informal is a letter which is personal, I told. Okay, you will be expressing your feelings. It can also be called a written conversation. Why? Because you will be directly speaking to the person whom you are writing the letter. Directly you share your feelings with the person to whom you are writing the letter. Okay, so like this, informal and formal. Formal means what I told, like it may be a complaint regarding some robbery, it may be, or some disturbance in your colony, or if any activity which took place is causing an effect, bad effect on your society or in your colony. That type of letters also you can write. And now example, just an example I am giving you. You are studying in a village. Just example I am giving you. Just imagine that you are studying in a village and you have, this is your examination time. And during your examination time, there is no proper RTC bus service. So you can write a request letter or a complaint letter to the officer in charge of that depot. So same way, okay. And municipal authorities, like if they are dug a road, okay, or some potholes are there, which are actually very dangerous while you are walking at night, even while you are driving on a vehicle also. So this type of complaints can be written to municipal commissioner of that particular area. So this type of letters are generally asked for you in the examination. Okay children, now we'll just see what the definition is. Okay, I'll just give what are the different types of letters or why they are used. Simple, in simple words, how they are used. Okay, then we'll see the layout or the components of both the type of letters, that is formal and informal. Then we'll see some model letters. Okay, first we'll see the definition, what it is. So today what we are going to learn, we are going to learn about letter writing. Okay children, now we'll start. So first, coming to what is a letter, simple definition I am giving you, ma'am. A letter is a written piece of communication, written piece of communication serving the purpose of writing the letter. Purpose of writing the letter. Remember this one. Next, coming to what is the reason? A letter is usually written with a purpose. Okay, with a purpose, either to provide information, either to provide information, okay, convey a message, request for a task to be done, request for a task to be done, or to report an issue. That is about some problem. To report an issue or some problem. Keep this in mind. Okay. Coming to the next part. So one more word I want to say, ma. Do you all really see letter writing these days? Where it is used? Previously, it was a very intimate part of a person's life, ma. Like when they used to share feelings with the people, and this sharing of feelings through letters used to create a very lovely relation between the persons who are living far away. That is, a person living in this village or in this state can write a letter. They used to write like that. Even when we were in our childhood, we used to use letter writing. So that was a very good entertainment and recreation for us to be in contact with the people who are far away from us. But nowadays it is restricted. What is the reason for this restriction? It is only because of the technological development. What we are doing, ma'am, if you want to speak to some person, in olden days there is no other chance. We used to write a letter, it used to take few days to reach the person, then the other person used to read it, then he used to reply. But nowadays it is not so. Because of that restriction, personally we are not using letter writing. But still it is in continuation of use in official purposes. Various official purposes, still they are using this letter writing. Did you get this point, ma'am? We will continue the lesson now. Look at this, ma. Is it clear for you all? So come on, look at this. Formal letter, that is format for writing a formal letter, or components, that is the parts which are included in the letter, what we should follow, the pattern to be followed. Now from, first should be from address, ma. And one more thing I am saying, previously this from address, to address, everything, from address used to be written on the right corner, like place and date of the person who is writing. And then again to address, to whom we are writing. What are the details to be written in the from address first? Name of the sender, address and date. And don't forget to put commas and full stops there.
Then next it comes, don't continuously write in the same pattern one. Just leave a line space. Then after that line space, write two address, that is name of the recipient, the person who is receiving the letter. Okay, sometimes in official letters, some places you need to mention the designation and name both. Okay, in some cases only designation will be enough. Like if you are writing the municipal commissioner, there is no need to write. But if you know the person to whom you are writing and his designation, you need to write the name and designation, the company name and address. Then what do you mean by salutation? Salutation is addressing the person. Okay, so like dear sir or madam. Okay, next subject. Subject is what? After the salutation, we should write the subject. Always remember, after salutation, we should write the subject. That is the reason for writing the letter. For formal letter means official letter, no? So the purpose of writing this official letter, you should write here under the subject. Then comes the body of the letter. Generally, the body is divided into three parts. Generally, it should be divided into 2 to 3 parts. Like introduction, okay? Introduction about what you are writing in the 1 or 2 sentences. Then later on, you should write the details of what you want to convey. Then finally, you should conclude it. Okay, like that it should be divided into 2 to 3 parts. Then it is also called, and then closing of the letter, it is otherwise called closing note or end note ma. Where what should be written in the end note or closing note? Yours sincerely is there, name and signature of the person. This is called the end note and the signature of the letter. So I hope you got a perfect idea about it. And now end note can also be written. Here I used only yours sincerely ma. There is no compulsion that you should use only yours sincerely. You can also use yours sincerely, yours truly, or yours faithfully, like that. And coming to the previous way of writing ma, generally you are having a habit of using respected sir. Did you see the letters being written respected sir, respected madam? So sorry, by using this word respected itself, you are okay respecting them. But to whom you are giving respect, sir, madam, okay, you are writing. But the word itself, but that is when you are addressing a person by using sir or madam itself, you are showing a respect. So that is the reason you can write, there is a change in the way of addressing a person by here. Either you can write respected sir in old way, or you can also write dear sir or dear madam. Remember this also. Okay children, now next one, I am going to give you one example. First I will read the question for what we are going to write the letter ma. Okay, then we will see the pattern. And the question is, write a letter to the editor of the local newspaper on the need to arrange public opinion against cruelty to animals. So you want to write a letter to the editor regarding the cruelty towards animals by our people in the society. Request the paper to educate the people regarding kindness to animals. This is the letter to whom it is asked to be written ma? To the editor of a local newspaper, you are writing the letter. So how to write the letter? Now I am showing you. See from address, your name will be there. So only when a name is particularly given in the question, you should write the name. Otherwise you should write XXX only. So particular colony name, house number, district and date. Okay, and two address, to whom it is asked to write, the editor. Okay, to the editor, Deccan Chronicle, Hyderabad. Next, what I wrote, dear sir. See this letter ma, this letter of mine is a protest against cruelty to animals. Would you mind publishing it in your daily? It has become a common feature of the teasing the animals. The oxen are made to pull heavy loads, dogs are beaten up and killed, monkeys are caught and made to do dance, even parrots are caged, lions and tigers are trapped to perform certain tricks in circus. The cruelty of man towards animals is going unchecked. People should realize that the animals are also living creatures. They cannot be ill-treated and tortured. Please enlighten the people regarding this cruelty towards animals. And this end note is also called superscription ma. So what is it used? Yours faithfully XXX. You know, you should not write your name unless it is asked to write. Is it clear ma? This example, we'll see another example now. Write a complaint letter about a robbery in your colony. So to whom you should write this when there is a robbery which took place in your colony ma? To whom you should write? So either to the CI, circle inspector of the police station, or sub inspector of the police station. So now we are going to write the letter. The previous format, what it used to be used, you can use either formats ma. There is no compulsory rule that first one should be used or this one should be used. As I told, you are going to write on the right corner, right top corner, address of the person who is writing, okay, address of the sender, okay. Then to whom you are writing the letter? To the sub-inspector, Ramathapur Police Station, Hyderabad. Sir, simply sir you can write, or dear sir you can write. Subject is what? Robbery in our colony. So that indicates about what you are writing the letter. Now, I am a resident of Venkat Reddy Nagar colony. I would like to complain about the robbery that took place in our colony yesterday. Yesterday, when our neighbors were out of station, a thief entered their house. He robbed all the valuable things from their home. He broke the main door and entered the house. Then silently he robbed everything. We came to know about this only in the morning. Our neighbors do not know about this. We as a concern, or we with a concern you can write, are giving a complaint. Please look into the matter and control thefts in our colony. Okay? Yours sincerely. So this is the other format which used to be used previously. Ma. So both are correct. You can use either of the formats. Is it clear, ma? I hope you understood now. Now, a simple question I am going to give you regarding this formal letter writing. So complete the letter and send it to me through WhatsApp so that I can check whether you have understood or not. See the question given for assignment, ma. So assignment question. The question is, to Municipal Commissioner about the problem of open manholes and the question given is you are a resident of Koti Hyderabad open manholes in your colony have become a source of danger for the pedestrians and vehicle owners Okay, now what you should do is the reason, the purpose of writing the letter is given now. Write a letter to the municipal commissioner complaining about the problem in 120 words. So like this the questions will be given in your exam. So you need to write the answer. And one more thing, the main point remember, as I told, just like your minor discourses, whenever you are starting a letter, start writing on a fresh page. You can continue the letter, but you can't start writing at the half of the page. Okay? So start writing with a fresh page. If you are not able to continue the same page, completing the same page, continue in the next page. Okay, children, I hope you understood how to write a formal letter. Okay? We'll continue with our informal letter in our next class.